Hey everybody, this is Rydo, and we're back to LEGO Indiana Jones, the original series. The original trilogy. Let's hop into the next level we need to do in free play. I'm hoping for a million studs, and it's not impossible. Not impossible that I'll actually get that much. If I do get a million studs, we have treasure times. Times six available to us, and that means we will multiply 8 by 6, which would give us 48 if I am correct in my math, which maybe I'm not. Multipliers. Multiplier of 48, which that would certainly be nice. Now, this level in particular is a little weird. We're gonna get our true adventure rather quickly here. Because we start off kind of in the basement of the castle, some kind of garage of the castle. Man, I'm getting some strange lagging right now. In the sense that it's lagging, but it's not locking up. And that's something we haven't seen before. So, just in the fact that it's doing something different, I find it kind of amazing. I wonder if it's possible my computer is like backing something up or something like that. Windows 10 game mode will come out pretty soon here, and ideally these things would start happening. Once that game mode comes out, if at all possible, I'm probably going to leave my computer in game mode always. Windows 10's updating system, and just you need to reset now is very unhelpful for most people who want to use the computer. I imagine a large percentage of people don't ever see it too, but it's still, for me, it comes up enough. So before I break these boxes, let's go over here. See, there's no path to this area. I literally just had to jump there. Around. Let's move over here and see what's back here. So, screaming. Well, I got it there, whether I meant to get it there or not. I'd almost prefer if the game lagged this way. A little bit of a fraction of a second is way better than what it's doing now, which is locking up completely. The only thing I could think that would be causing this, honestly, is when I started recording, I hit start and then I undid start. Like really fast. Which, again, shouldn't affect anything, but that would be the assumption of what would happen in a properly programmed game, not this game. So I'm at 150,000, and we've got a little bit more to do. Fix this one, and then get all of the coins, and then immediately drive it into the lake. And just slowly So we're trying to get this thing on the platform. There we go. And out we are. That'd be weird if my hard drive was full. There's no reason why it should be full, though. Yep. I'm seeing it, too. I'm seeing low frame rate. So, if you're ever one of those persons that says they can't see the difference between 60 frames per second and 30 frames per second, for the people who can see the difference, it's like seeing this. This is probably an exaggerated but very accurate example. Personally, I don't even know if I would claim myself as being somebody who can always 100% tell the difference between 60 frames and 30. But right now you're looking at about 12. Trying to have a quicker experience here. So now here's the trick. I need to push the button to jump on the jump. Which that's something that never gets reused in LEGO games. We never have a point where you have to speed up the jump. Normally in games, if you're seeing this level of performance, you'd expect it to fix itself and not show its head again for a while. Not for it to consistently be an issue. Let's see. Open this here. Blow up some more things. Open the gate. And again, hopping this and make an amazing recovery. Gotta crank this up. I wouldn't be really surprised if a lot of this level is reused in a different part of the game. That from a different camera angle, this could be the path that we go up and down in the elephant. With the elephant in the second game. This could be sections added and taken away from other parts. We're going for double lag here. Amazing. I should just go try to completely overclock my video card. Just max it out. Max performance. Let's see. And all the benchmarks and tests I did, it didn't seem to matter for the amount of noise the fans made. It only slightly improved. Like one or two frames difference. I did the whole shebang. Benchmarks. Every benchmark I could find. But that would be ironic, and that'd really suck too. If I find some solution to this, then probably not immediately, but eventually I feel like I have to go make good and replay all the Lego games that lagged and say, well, sorry for that. Because I didn't overclock my video card. But I don't think I've underclocked my video card either. It's on like the normal setup. What it would be for a normal person who had my card, which I think that's a fair, more than fair depiction of the game, considering I have a pretty expensive video card, not the top of the line, but a GTX 970 is not something that is just completely overpowered. I've yet to see minimum requirements on games say you can't have this card or that card's too old. I played a game called the Talus Principle on my laptop before I built my computer that I'm using now, and it suffered quite a bit because of that, of just being played on a laptop and a mobile video card. And I keep intending at some point to get back to it and playing it, but it's really, really hard to look at the list of the 500 games I have available to me on Steam and that I've purchased. I say it like I somehow magically won some lottery and got all those games that I purchased them all. When you look at that list, it's really hard to play something that you've already played, or at least recently played. There was also a problem with that because they came out with DLC for that game, and took me forever to be able to justify purchasing the DLC, and I haven't ever gotten around to playing it, even though I now own the DLC. That's a problem with, I guess, YouTubers in general, I would guess, as far as DLC goes, is that if you're a YouTuber like most YouTubers and you only play games as they're right now hot, coming out that day to get all the views, you're never really going to come back and play the DLC unless you can play some game for the entire duration. Resident Evil 7 is out right now. If YouTubers are playing that, the DLC comes out supposedly a week later on PlayStation, so if they can keep their series going for 1 week, then they can do that. But most games, it's a month later, and a lot of YouTubers, they start games and then they see they're not getting very many views, and they give up and they don't even bother to finish the games, and that's something I just don't enjoy myself, so it's not something I would want to do on my channel. I'd rather play a game all the way to the end, because I'm gonna play it to the end anyways, and let the views go where they may. Even to my own YouTube channel's detriment. There's a lot of things certainly I know I could probably do that would increase my YouTube channel viewership, but the trade-off is then it stops becoming my YouTube channel. It becomes just a pandering YouTube channel that does whatever it thinks it can get away with to get views. And eventually the people who do come to see that type of content will get bored and leave, and I'll be upset with myself for making that kind of content. That's, I suppose, also one of the benefits of doing mostly retrospectives, is I can look at old games and say, look at this old game that you could probably get on Steam for sale for $10 is it worth playing now in 2017? Now, sadly for the Lego games, they are worth playing, it's just not in this form factor. And I would heavily recommend doing research before you even bought it, like, used on the 360, but I can, from what I recall, the 360 versions of these games worked flawlessly. I guess there's no reason to continuously open that thing. Dig this. This is a weird thing to dig out of the ground. Instead of build. And the little squares around it don't make the most sense. It's like, why? Trying to get as many studs as possible. So I fix it twice, and we've got this tractor, and then this tractor can come out. And what's the tractor gonna do? See, the tractor goes over these squares. Ah, I see. And they grow big carrots. And is that our final collectible? Yes, it is. So there's kind of no point. Stand on the switch won't work, so I'll take the tractor and see if I can roll on the switch with the tractor. There was something else in that room, but we've already collected it, so. Notice how the vehicle's not breaking. Instead, it's just hopping me out. My companion. Doesn't look like I can blow up these You can see she's glitching all over the place. Let's just set that back up. Finally. And do we really have anything more we need to do? No, we could probably just save and exit right now. We're not as high as I would like to be in studs, but that might just be the best we can get, particularly as we're dealing with all new set of problems. Maybe I need to exit. Maybe I need to figure out what's going on. And are we done when we go through here? No, we aren't. So we've got a whole nother area. I played pretty thoroughly, and it's another example of we had most of the characters we needed to do most of the things anyways. Otherwise, I wouldn't have two entire sections here that I've already collected everything for. So I'm just going berserk here. Blowing up as much as possible. Is there anything in here besides that? No. Let's see, I could make the... I could make the plants and get another collectible and maybe get some studs, but I kind of don't even think it's worth it. There's nothing back here. Just need to blow this up one final time. So like, yeah, I can do this, and I guess that's worth it because they are giving me blue dots and blue studs are kind of worth it. See, this could possibly have been Lego right here. Just playing rocket tag with bad guys. Yeah, this would be a little too violent though. If this is kind of why when you see Splatoon on the Nintendo systems that it's about shooting paint and painting the sides of the playfield and not shooting paint at each other and just 100% attacking and hurting the enemy. It's too violent for a kid's game or for what you would hope. I think a rocket's there collided. Alright, so I think I've done everything. We're at 809,000 studs. Treasure times 8. We got True Adventurer, which hopefully will multiply to a couple hundred thousand. Yes, we're over the amount we needed. So now we will get treasure times 6, and it will be a short process. Probably less than the entire run of the next level to get what we need for treasure times 8. Now we still need to find treasure times 10. Not really a big issue. Not really a big issue at all. You see, that was an average level that was made longer. It was probably a slightly shorter level if we weren't having micro lagging on top of regular lagging. See, 4 million, if we could afford it, we could almost skip treasure times 6. But not necessary, really. So then we come over to extras. Treasure times 6. Now we have a multiplier of 48 studs. And where are we? We're at 480,000 studs. That's 1,000 for a silver now. 10,000 probably. Well, not quite a multiplier of 100. If it's 48, it's half of that. So how much will I get for just doing this much? Yeah, it's about 200,000 studs. We still don't have enough to do that area. Let's see, what is this supposed to be a picture of? Gilt frame portrait?
Interesting. So, if I ran in here every single time, you're talking almost 200,000 studs. It's now to the level where it starts to make sense to break these things and get the tiny amount of studs you were getting before and work our way to maybe the parcel detector and the other things. But I still don't want to purchase any of those things. I still feel like the right move is to save up to 4 million and then get score times 8, and in the remaining levels, since that was number 3, so in number 4, number 5, or number 6, probably number 6, I would guess we get score times 10 as the parcel. And see, we now are down to only needing 18 gold bricks, 3 true adventurers, and if we missed any true adventurers with a score of multiplier of 48, we could get that in less than a few minutes in a level, and we need to get 4 parcels. So we are making good progress. That's gonna be it for this recording. We're at 73.7. I'm gonna go ahead and exit out after this recording, see what's going on, and check on my computer, because micro lagging doesn't make sense. As always, I ask you to like, share, subscribe, comment if you want to, and watch every second of my videos. If you want a friend to follow me on basically any social media sites, there's a whole bunch of links down below. Thank you for watching. Have a good evening.